you want to get started with Blockbench. In this video, we're going through every tool needed to create a base model. We're going to start by opening a model by going to File, New, Generic Model. For now, the format is not important since it can be changed later. Then you are presented with the project settings. Here you see the format you selected, the name that will be displayed on the file, the identifier for the code, the way the texture mapping is created, texture mapping meaning how the texture is applied to the model, and lastly, the size of the texture. All of these settings can be changed after creating the model, so don't worry about them.
First of all, make sure you have a mouse for maximum efficiency. To use the correct keybindings, go to File, Preferences, Keybindings, then go to Load Keymap and select Default Mouse and click OK. To rotate the camera, hold middle mouse button and drag. To pan the camera, hold middle mouse button plus Shift and drag. You can zoom by scrolling your mouse wheel.
The north direction, aka the front, is marked by this N. Pressing Tab will toggle quad view, giving you cameras along each axis. To get started modeling, make sure you're in the Edit tab. This can be selected in the top right corner. First thing you do is to create a cube by going to the Outliner window and clicking Add Cube or by pressing Ctrl plus N. It can be renamed by double-clicking the text. You can select the cube in the view or in the Outliner. You can unselect it by clicking at the bottom of the Outliner. You can move it around with the Move tool in the toolbar or by pressing V. By dragging the arrows, it can be moved along the X, Y, and Z axis. It will move over by 1 pixel at a time, but if you hold Ctrl, it will drag 1/10 of a pixel, and if you hold Shift, it will drag 1/4. You can see in the bottom left corner how much you're moving it by. You can also move it by dragging the position box in the element window, or you can type in the exact number you want. To undo, click Ctrl plus C or Z, depending on how you say it. To scale it, select the Resize tool next to the Move tool or press S. Then move the boxes that appear to extend it in the directions that you want. Again, you can also change it by dragging the position boxes or typing the number that you want. The fourth box here is the inflate number, which will expand the cube in all directions by a set number. This is useful for making layers over existing cubes, like the hat layer on the Minecraft skin. If you want to quickly switch between move and resize, press space. Now, rotation happens around a pivot point. Every cube has their own pivot point, and it can be changed by selecting the pivot tool or pressing P, then dragging it around. It can also be changed with the pivot point boxes. You can also click Center Pivot next to this to put the pivot point in the exact center of the cube. To rotate, select the rotation tool or press R, then drag the cube along the rotation axis that you want. Again, you can change the rotation by using the rotation boxes. By default, it will rotate 2.5 degrees at a time. If you hold Ctrl, it will move 1 degree at a time, and if you hold Shift, it will move 22.5 degrees, 1/16 of a circle. If you want to quickly switch between rotation and pivot point, press space. Now, when you move a cube, you'll notice that the pivot point moves along with it. This is because you have the transform space mode set to bone. This means you're changing the cube in relation to the group it's in, though since it's not in any groups, it's the same as global transform mode. If you change transform mode to local, you'll notice that the angle of the axis change, since you're now changing the cube in relation to its own rotation, and when you move it, it will not change the pivot point. You can also change the cube's rotation mode, which works the same. The Vertex Snap tool can also be accessed from the toolbar or by pressing X, and this can be used to snap together two vertices, which basically means corners. To use it, select the first cube, then the corner you want to move, then the second cube, then the corner you want to connect it to. You can also change Snap mode to Scale to make the cube scale to that point instead of moving. You can duplicate a cube by clicking it in the Outliner while holding Alt, then dragging it away or by pressing Ctrl plus D. If you right-click the cube, you can go to the Marker color and change its color. You can select multiple cubes at once by holding Ctrl and clicking them in the view or in the Outliner. If you hold Shift and click another cube in the Outliner, you can select a range. If you press Ctrl plus A, you will select everything in the model. If you press Ctrl plus I, you will invert the selection, unselecting your current selection and selecting everything else. If you press Ctrl plus F, you get a selection menu where you can select all cubes with a certain name, marker color, or texture. Instead of choosing all, you can also choose a random amount by dragging the random bar to the left. If you drag it to the middle, it will select a random half. You can also choose if it's going to add to your existing selection or if it's going to select between the currently selected cubes. These selection options can also be found under Edit in the top menu bar. To rename all elements of a certain name, select everything, then go to Edit, Find Replace. If you want to hide a cube, click the eye next to it. If you want to hide everything except your selection, press I. If you want to lock it to prevent any accidental changes, select Toggle More Options, then click the padlock symbol. You can now no longer select it. To unlock all elements, go to Edit, Unlock All. Clicking the camera symbol and the More Options will prevent that element from exporting. To add a group, go to the Outliner and click Add Group, or hit Ctrl plus G. The group is automatically named Bone, and we call them Bones because groups have their own pivot points separate from all the cubes within it, which are used as the joints for animations. It is generally a good idea to rename your groups to keep track of them. To add the cubes to the group, just click and drag into the folder. Now when you rotate the bone, all those cubes will rotate along with it. When you move anything within the group in bone transform mode, it will move in relation to the group. In global transform mode, it will ignore the group and move in relation to the normal axis. If you have a group selected and add a cube, it will be added to that group. If you have multiple cubes selected and create a group, it will group them together. You can also add a group within a group, meaning everything in this group will move dependently on the group above. To hide a group in the outliner, click the drop-down arrow. If you go to the top menu and select Transform, there are some more tools here. First off is Transform Scale. This gives you the ability to scale not just cubes, but also groups. To use it, select the element you want to scale, then select the Scale tool. Here you can select the scale factor. If you type in 2, it will be twice as big. You can also change the origin point where the scaling will happen from. Element Pivot makes it the same as your selected element, and Selection Center makes it the center of all your selected elements. If you're scaling a lot of groups, it's best to set the origin point to 0. Lastly, you can uncheck certain axes to stop scaling in those directions. Transform Rotate can be used to permanently rotate elements without the use of pivot points. The rotation happens around global origin. This can be useful if you make your model face the wrong way. Transform Flip lets you mirror elements along the global axes. This does work with groups and everything in them. If you, for example, want to mirror an arm and a leg, you can simply select the bone and choose Flip X to flip them along the x-axis. Transform Center lets you center your models along the global axes. You can also add anchor points by clicking Add Locator. This can be used to set origin points for particles and attachment points for leashes and so on. And with that, you have all the tools needed to make a model. In the next video, you're going to learn how to texture it.